Today I'm gonna address one of the most common problems we content creators face while screencasting is about nested sequence. Most of us have different kinds of laptops and all of them don't have the same dimensions, rather the same aspect ratio of the screen. But when we are making YouTube videos, we need to stick to the 2:1 aspect ratio or the 16:9 aspect ratio. When we import the screen recordings into the timeline, most of the edges gets chopped off, like what you can see here. The problem is that when we try to edit most of the screen recordings and we try to achieve any kind of effects like zooming in or zooming out, those effects won't be consistent throughout the entire video. Like this video is zoomed in while this portion is not. In order to achieve consistent effects, we need to merge all these small clips. What essentially most of us think is that we can add an adjustment layer over all of these layers, and then we can add the effects over this adjustment layer so that it affects all the layers below it. But when you try to zoom in the adjustment layer, you will see that nothing happens, because most of the time these layers won't work with the adjustment layers. Adjustment layers works best with the color grading tools. So what we have to do is that we have to nest the entire sequence by right clicking and then nest. Now, as you can see, if we zoom in any portion of the video, the whole sequence will be zoomed in and the effect will be streamlined. But here another problem arose is that if we try to adjust the position of the video, then as you can see, the portions of the video which was outside the frame are completely chopped off. But here your brother is gonna tell you an easy fix for this issue. Just double click the nested sequence and now a new timeline will be opened. And also, the remaining portions of the video which were initially chopped off are restored in this timeline. So here we need to know what are the dimensions in which we recorded our screen. For example, in my case, I recorded my screen in OBS Studio and I recorded it in 2160 by 1350. So what I will essentially do is that I will go over to the sequence settings and I will change the frame size of the nested sequence to 2160 by 1350. Let's press enter, and as you can see, the 8:5 aspect ratio is now restored. Let's press OK. And as you can see, the whole portion of the video is there. Let's just press Ctrl S or Command S if you're using a Mac, and let's cross the nested sequence. And now tada, the whole portion of the video of the nested sequence in our original sequence is now recovered. So this is a simple trick which I found out and also felt like sharing it with you, as many creators don't know about this trick. You can also check your own screen recording settings. If you are using OBS Studio, just go over to the settings. Just go to the video tab and here, as you can see, it's 2160 by 1350 for my case. And also, if you are a new OBS user, then I will recommend you to keep both these values equal. So that's it for today, guys. Hope you have enjoyed this video. Make sure to subscribe and turn on the bell icon so that you get notified whenever I upload a new video. Also, if you have any other suggestions in mind, then please mention them in the comment section below. Until then, stay creative and I hope to see you in my next video.